What's going on, everyone? This is Jordan with Conquer Trading and Investing, and it's that time of the week. It's time for our weekly Forex forecast and analysis for the upcoming week of May the 4th through the 8th. What a week this has been. We have so much to review here. We have so much to plan out for the week ahead. Let's start this right now. Let's kick this off. Let's take a look here at the DXY, and you can see this is the most important chart to be looking at right now. It looks like the dollar has just flipped this support. We need to see a retest over here. We closed below the resistance here at 98.85. Excuse me, the support of 98.85. This should now be resistance. One of two things are going to happen. Either next week on Monday, we're going to see a retest of this level to confirm that it has turned from support to resistance, or we're going to bleed down all the way into this next area of support, 98.30. That's a big level. That's a really big level. If we lose that level, the bearish momentum here on the DXY is really going to start to accelerate. At least that's what we'll be looking out for. And I think we could see some really, really, really further lows against the dollar. Now, what I want you to be aware of over here is just what transpired, what's happened. We had the breakout to the upside of this triangle. We broke out to the upside. And then since we came into this resistance here right around 101, it's been 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 straight down days taking out this level of support at 98.85. This is now turning to be a false breakout to the upside, and it looks like the important level next week is going to be whether or not 98.30 holds. Now, some of you might be asking, is this really bearish the dollar? Is the current environment bearish the dollar? Jordan, we have this enormous dollar shortage, a $14 trillion shortage across the world. Deflation is kicking in. Oil traded negative recently. That's deflationary. People need dollars, and there's a lack of dollars. Shouldn't that provide a bid and demand under dollars? The other side of that is that the Fed just expanded their balance sheet by $4 trillion. U.S. government, another $2 trillion, right? Those things are definitely very net negative for the U.S. dollar. And that could have a near-term impact. At the end of the day, we just follow what's on the charts. We live, right, on the swing traders time frame. So we're looking at things day-to-day, more or less, on a 1 to 5 days out. And that's where we're able to kind of get a really good feeling for the flow of the market and make a nice living. We don't need to project what we're going to be seeing on the US dollar 2 weeks from now, 2 months from now, or 2 years from now. We just need to focus on what's in front of us. And right now, this broke down important support. It looks like it's now resistance down up at 98.85. And now it's time to definitely be leaning against the dollar and see what happens. If we break 98.30, that should accelerate. All right, now let's take a look at Bitcoin. Bitcoin obviously had a very nice week. Most importantly, Bitcoin took back this resistance line over here. This was support until during the financial crisis, it broke down outside of that support. I do believe if we never had that liquidity crisis, Bitcoin never would have broken that support. We've been monitoring this, waiting for this to come back up and retake this resistance, this trendline resistance, which it has. You can see the consolidation over here in this area before the breakout. We broke all the way straight up like a runaway train into the resistance at 94.75. From there, we came back down to the support at 8.470. And then have since traded back up to resistance at 9,100. This is obviously very bullish. If you've been following the channel, if you've been following our weekly Forex updates, you know this has been the plan all along. You know where we were watching out if things got dicey on the downside and all bets were off. But we've been walking you through all of this, expecting this to happen. Here's what's next. Because it's one thing to know what was going to happen, but what's going to happen next, right? Until we break this upper resistance over here, connecting the high, all-time high, to this next midterm swing high in June of 2019. Once that trend line is broken, the bull market phase has begun. Right now, as we're approaching the halving in about 10 days, we should stay within this range over here. Any pullback to support at 8,200 and or this trend line over here is a fantastic place to accumulate Bitcoin going into the halving. On the channel's playlist, there's a Bitcoin playlist that is well presented, well researched. Do go ahead and watch those first three videos. They're very important. Now, what happens? Should you be accumulating Bitcoin here? Yes. Should you be accumulating Bitcoin down over here if that opportunity presents itself? Yes. Do I think we'll break down below this trendline support again? No, I do not. What happens when we break above this trendline to the upside? That's the place, if you're not yet inside Bitcoin, to make sure you get in Bitcoin. Don't worry. Probably what's going to happen is we trade up to somewhere around $14,000 and then have a 30% pullback, probably to the resistance turn support at 10,400. That will give you another chance. During the bull market phase, there will be more than a few, up to several 30% pullbacks on Bitcoin. Each one of those is an opportunity for you to reposition yourself and get in. Be careful trading in and out in Bitcoin during the bull market phase. A lot of traders are going to get left behind. There are going to be violent moves to the upside, and people are going to be buying in at a higher price than they sold. Now's the time to accumulate and hold. We are 0 to 3 months away from calling it the bull market in Bitcoin, and therefore crypto has begun. All right, let's take a look at gold right now. Now, I'm going to drop down to the 8-hour time frame here just to give you a better look at what's going on. I don't need to review. You've been following the updates. You know that once this trend line was broke, that was the entry. I myself did not get a piece of it. But then over here, you had another opportunity as we tested this broken resistance as support as it resumed off to take a nice trade. This is on the break of this blue trend line where we advised to take profits and exit those positions. And then we became neutral on gold. Now, long term, of course, we are very bullish on gold in this environment with quantitative easing taking place. This is where gold thrives as the global monetary money supply is expanded. You're going to see gold repriced, as well as there is that demand from central banks and sovereign nations who are buying gold, getting ready for the eventually financial system reset. Those who hold the gold will get a seat at the table. We're very bullish on gold, but not near term. Here's where we took profits. Up in here, this resistance. Again, we cautioned everyone again who took this. This was during our live stream. If you're not yet part of our live streams, every day, 9 o'clock, Monday through Friday in the morning, 9 a.m. Eastern time, we live stream, take a look at all the markets. Do join us. Over here, we had another opportunity to get long, and then this is where we took profits into the resistance and went neutral. Above this resistance over here opens up looking to get long as we are then probably breaking out hard and fast and maybe have the opportunity to test the all-time high up around 1900 and probably eventually break it. Now, I was not looking to lean into the support. Again, it's 1640 while I would look to lean in buy or even down at 1580. Aside from that, I'm just staying neutral until we break above this resistance. And then at that point, I'll look to get into gold. And or I will take an opportunity if we trade down to either one of these supports, price holds and resumes off it to get long on gold as well. All right, let's take a look at the US dollar, Japanese yen. The yen has been strong. The yen has been bid, especially Friday, as we saw a really big bid into risk off. We're going to take a look at the Australian dollar, Japanese yen in just a moment. First, let's take a look at this. Then we'll look at the euro, US dollar. This has been not easy to trade the last couple of days because we broke down below this support over here. We flipped it into resistance. It gave a nice or a potential short opportunity. That trade would have been stopped out, no question about it. And now you could see on Friday, we resumed down and again closed below that support. So that it has not been easy at all to trade the last couple of days. Nevertheless, take a step back. We're losing this important area of support. You could see once we get past these lows that we put in this week, it really opens up the downside. I don't know that the US dollar is the best pair to play versus the Japanese yen, but I will tell you this, if we do see an acceleration of that dollar weakness and we continue to see yen strength, it absolutely will be. So this is not a trade that I want to get left behind on. And I'm focused in on it. I'm going to take another shot at it next week. As long as we start resuming downwards, I'll look to enter that trade and see, and hopefully the second time is where it works out. Euro US dollar, taking a look here. Euro was able to actually take advantage of the dollar weakness late into the week. And definitely, finally, we had a relief rally off of this on the verge of breaking down a pretty important level down at 1.0776. Instead, Euro was able to actually bounce up and is currently stuck at this. And look how heavy this resistance is. It's an important resistance that we have over at 1.0995. You could see, follow me along, that this has been multiple times a point of a pretty strong support flipped to resistance over here, and we were not able to close above it on Friday. We'll watch what happened next week. I remain firm in that we need to regain the 1.0995 level, the thick line over up here, in order to say, all right, definitely wrong here, and now we have a bullish bias on the euro. And not only that, there's a good chance we're going to come up, test the resistance at 1.2827, and possibly even test the highs right about 1.15. I want to take a look at what happens if we are able to break out that high, just so you have some type of perspective. Look, you see this trend line? And let me pull back even further. Do you see this trend line? If we break over here 1.15, there's a good chance that that is going to be the true test between the bulls and the bears. And that's in play. That's entirely possible. On the same time, as we come into this area of resistance next week on the euro, the dollar still has a possibility. The dollar still has a possibility. Remember, on the DXY, it's 98.30 that we're looking at. A break below will send up, and that will be here, breaking above this level on the euro of 1.10995. Until then, this could still reverse. And if it does, it's a beautiful opportunity to pick up the euro US dollar still. If we do wind up breaking below this level of support, at that point, we're going to see some significant lows on the euro. So the euro US dollar, why it's in play for watching and what is developing, this is not yet something that we want to, that is tradable or that we're looking for opportunity. There's plenty of opportunity out there. There's opportunity every day. It's a question of doing your analysis and waiting for that opportunity so you could take advantage of it. That's what this is all about. That's why we spend all this time going over the charts, keeping in the flow of the market and doing our analysis. Right now, there's much better opportunities. I would stand aside on the euro US dollar, but we are getting close to a potential level where we got to take possibly the breakout to the upside, but we're coming in to also an area of strong resistance and going to have to continue to see what happens on those levels next week. All right, let's keep going. Let's look at the pound US dollar over here. The pound actually had a funny close today on Friday. You could see that it broke above this resistance over here. I should flip that over to support, although it's kind of still fuzzy right now, over at 1.25. It broke above there Thursday, came into the area of near-term resistance, was rejected. And with the weak dollar on Friday, you could see that the pound actually was a lot weaker than the dollar. So that provides a little bit of pause for concern, and probably better to wait and see what happens on Monday. As you could see, it could go either way from where it is. Now, the best thing to do is now come down to the 8-hour and wait and watch. Is that line over here, this resistance, the best place to actually have it? I mean, that's up for discretion. I would think that maybe we could put that down 20 or so pips and give us a little bit better read going into next week. Let's actually do that. I would still say this is support right now. As you can see, it's above this resistance area here. It's above the resistance right here, and it's above the resistance right here. So we're gonna call that support going into Friday, which means if we do start hold this support and resume off of it, at that point, yes, that opens up alongside buy side trades on the pound US dollar as early as London on Monday. Now, if we do break down below this, give it a little bit of room. I would say watch for this level down here. Let's see what happens over there. Maybe the pound will find its footing and also be able to resume up. But that's the line in the sand. Get below 1.244. And that point, we're looking to trade. We're looking, as this is now in a downtrend that's broken below this important area, we'll be looking below 1.243 to go ahead and sell that. Here's a look at the Australian dollar, Japanese yen. We did see a big bid into risk off on Friday. Here's the pair to look at for risk on, risk off. Australian dollar, when people are more minded to take on risk, they generally use the Australian dollar as a risk pair. Now, Japanese yen is always that safe haven flows, is always the risk off pair. You could see what happened was on Friday. Friday, Donald Trump kind of put a little bit of pressure on China, holding them responsible for the whole virus situation, and as well as reigniting the trade war, which obviously if he's elected next year, the market's going to start being forward-looking. And if it looks like he's getting reelected, the market's going to expect, I think, further friction over there. At least that's what I am leaning towards. Nevertheless, technically, you could see in this ugly, ugly, ugly sell-off during the crisis, we've since put in a low, retraced. This is where we're looking to lean into the first opportunity into strong resistance and sell. This support over here, you see that resistance turned support, is what held. Market took out this strong resistance and then came into the next area of resistance where it's being rejected. Right now, this is again turning very, very bearish. As long as we're below the resistance at 69.20, definitely looking for opportunities to short this pair. This is going to be an interesting level. If we're able to break below 67.60, expect further downside momentum. Below 66.56, that probably means that things are really falling apart all over the place. And we are looking on the equity markets of retesting the lows and or making lower lows. Speaking of which, if you do not get a chance yet to see the S&P 500 technical analysis video going into the weekend, do take a moment in the description below. You'll find a link to that and you could go ahead and watch that video. Listen, everyone, I hope you had a wonderful week. Enjoy your weekend. I look forward to tomorrow. I look forward to sharing with you more. We're going to kick it off tomorrow with the live stream, 9 o'clock in the morning. We're going to review everything that happened overnight during Asia in London and get ourselves positioned well for the week ahead. Hope you all have a great weekend, and I'll talk to you tomorrow.